Okay, we have made it into Denerim. We have chosen our party, and we are about to go plunging into battle against these friggin' darkspawn sons of bitches and hopefully take down the archdemon. First step, I'm going to go to the market district, because, well, shit's going down there, and I want to take care of it. Oh, I got level ups I can deal with. Oh, ogres! Let's make them some bitches dead. But you probably killed the emissary at first. Yeah, now, there we go. Okay, kill the ogre, dammit. I do like the one of the ideas they really never had. It's not really a truly unique thing in any real way. I've seen this kind of thing done in lots of... Oh, get your ass out of there, bro. It's not a truly unique thing, because I've seen this kind of stuff done in these fantasy settings before. Ah, kill it, kill it! Okay, there we go. What I'm talking about is the decision to have, there be multiple sort of antagonists. And antagonists on, multiple levels, that is. If you ask in this game who the main antagonist is, the obvious choice is Loghain, and there's a whole mess of layers to that concept of Loghain being the main antagonist of this game. He's the human antagonist, all this, that, and the other. He's the one that's most directly responsible for you getting, for your position in the world, and why Ferelden is unable to truly deal with the Blight as it comes. But on the other hand, there is also the part about the Blight being the Archdemon. And that's another sort of antagonist, but that's a different kind of thing. The Archdemon doesn't really have any sort of personality to it. I mean, it's supposedly intelligent, but it never really displays that to us. It's more or less just sort of a beast that needs to be killed. And the Blight is presented as kind of like a force of nature, even though it's an army, and it's a sort of infection that spreads whenever Darkspawn goes. It's a sort of way that the story sort of works with it, to kind of... This damn thing is still... Oh, the Galaster. Okay, I'm going to, as we're proceeding through Denerim, I am going to take a little bit of a detour to try and seek out some of the more powerful Darkspawn commanders in order to sort of weaken the Darkspawn infrastructure before I take on the Archdemon. So here in the Market District, we're going to be fighting the first of these, and it's going to take me a little while to get there. So I'm going to be taking out a bunch of ogres and that kind of shit before we have a chance to actually take out the main bad guys. Also note that we have the ability to summon armies. And I'm gonna go in... I mean, you don't really need to do this. It's not terribly necessary. But I'm going to bring in the elves to join us in the fight here. The elves are really good at ranged attacks, not particularly good for close up. That's really what I want for. I'm going to rely mostly on my own character's abilities to maintain close range stuff while the elves go and fight a pistols. Oh, get over there and help him out. almost broke my own promise there. Okay, elves, help me out here. Ogre. And now I have their help and they can help me take out the commander up ahead. This is actually the second time I've had to record this episode. The game kept crashing on me before, so I was like, okay, I'm just gonna go back and start the area fresh, see if that helps. One thing I kind of like about this, and this is by no means a unique thing, other stories and other games and all that kind of stuff have all done this kind of shit before. But I do like the difference between that we have where there is the... A main antagonist of the game is obviously Loghain. She's the one that's basically like given us all of this trouble that we have to go and deal with. She's the reason why the Darkspawn army was allowed to destroy Kallen's army. If he didn't do what he did, the whole situation would end up being quite a bit less of a problem than it ended up actually being. Where are my elves? Oh, they're back. But of course, there's a demon breaking package, and he is no longer alive, although it's possible in the game if you wanted to, you would have allowed him to live and actually join your group here, but now still would have had to leave the deal by himself. Just in general, he's the one that's gotta die. I'm about to take out my warden for the side. Nice job, he healed, not me. Come on, elves, do your freaking job. Take them down. Hate to have to use a D3 kit to restore Alistair. Now, Loghain is the human antagonist in this, and there's kind of fundamental difference in the way that works from something like the Archdemon. The Archdemon is really just sort of the head of... Aha, there you are. Wow, look at all this stuff. While the Archdemon is said to be intelligent and all that kind of stuff, we really don't see... What the... We don't really see the... effective on this game, for the most part, because it comes across as a sort of vicious and powerful monster, as opposed to an intelligent, calculating leader of an army of demonic creatures. It just so it comes across as a monster, and that's basically how we're going to be seeing it as it's just a monster. But of course, that's not really going to do that good for us if you want to have a more personal story against an antagonist. You're going to need someone a little more like, well, Loghain was. Loghain being a human antagonist, kind of, as I was saying before, takes a different perspective on the entire thing. Hold on, I'm going to save. Every grade school child, when being taught about the structure of a story, is taught about story conflict. After all, conflict is what builds stories, what stories are built from. And well, you think about it like that, and they tend to boil it down. I'm going to the alienage. They tend to boil it down to a very simplistic concept of there being three types of conflict. These are rather crude generalizations, So it's not quite accurate, but hold on, there's some elves I'm going to talk to. This place is remarkably untouched. I guess even the Darkspawn don't like going into the alienage.
You! It's you! The Maker sure gave you the gift of good timing, didn't he? There's a large group of Darkspawn approaching and the gates won't hold. We need your help.
Just get out of my way.
They're breaking through!
Run, all of you! Run for your lives!
Time for some killing! I guess I can't summon... Oh, yeah, here again. Let's get the elves back in. For, you know, reasons. Oh, shit. Look at that. Haha. Start killing.
So be it.
Okay, apparently... I'm gonna have to do this. I tried to take him out before they got there. Where are my elves, anyway? Well, as I was saying, all these storylines, they boil the concept down to a rather simplistic concept of the three types of conflict. And those conflicts would be the person versus person, where the kind of strike that we have with low game is person versus environment, where a person is sort of like trying to overcome sort of possibly physical challenge, but something presented by the world that they live in. Or like, let's say a person is in a plane crash and the story is about them trying to survive that. That would be a person versus environment. Or if it's something like a wolves or something like that. That's a person trying to survive the environment. Now my elves are showing up. Sons of bitches, could have used your help a little few seconds ago. Here's the giant. Oh shit, I'm about to fall in battle. Restore fool! Ah, you son of a bitch. If you look at it that way, there's also the concept of person versus self, which is the person trying to overcome their own difficulties or whatever, their own personal demons. Say, for example, the person who's a drug addict, or the person who's themselves trying to overcome some undesirable trait about themselves. I'm gonna die in that. Okay, it looks like I'm gonna win this one. I already took down the general. Oh, yeah. Well, there we go. It's dead.
It has begun.
Oh, that's crappy. Well, we'll take the Denerim potion in the ring, though. So, of that group, I would definitely say that the greater threat, obviously, is the threat of that the Archdemon is. The large, imposing thing that's going to end up destroying all of Ferelden if we do nothing about it. But that's that's sort of like that person versus environment kind of situation. Whereas and it's a very impersonal kind of antagonist to have. How you doing?
You saved many lives here today. Thank you. Please, take this. I pray it helps you in your coming battles. We have to go. May the Maker watch over you.
Yeah, we are pretty badass about that, you know, saving lives and all that shit. But, I mean, the Archdemon is such an impersonal kind of enemy. It doesn't really have a personality to be dealing with. It doesn't know who you are. It doesn't care. It just sees the entire world as being something for it to steamroll across. And there is a certain... Oh. Well, that sucks. Can't go that way. Well, anyway, I mean, it's showing up, it's kicking her ass, it's doing all that. It's an impersonal enemy, and you can't build a strong character-oriented story. You can, obviously, but not in this kind of situation, where the enemy is just this thing, which is where the whole low-gain concept obviously came. But anyway, we've taken care of the two generals, and I am now moving on.